Mandy's head. Does that make any kind of sense? Your word was entrepreneur. Okay. That is not a bad word. God bless those who, you know, who are entrepreneurs, you know, and what they do, because it provides this kind of thing. It's a matter of how you use those resources and how you do that in a real Christ-like context. Did I answer it?
Yeah.
I didn't avoid it?
Yes.
I didn't spin it? We're in the no spin, we're in the spin era in the next 6 weeks. Any more questions? Yeah.
This isn't at all music related, but I was just curious how you were in that. It's not at all music related, but how did you meet your wife here? Just curious.
Oh, she just kept bugging me. We were both teaching at Alexander High School. She was down the hall substituting in French. And so I said to my kids, I was 27, I was not looking for a wife. I enjoyed being single. I was going to be single the rest of my life. And I said, who's the new little French teacher now? I said, her name is Gloria Sickle. I should have been warned by that last name, Sickle. But that was an attempted humor, not a good one. But so the kid said, hey, I said, is she sick? He said, yeah. So I took her out to lunch for two or three times. And she said that she knew I was serious when after the third time I offered to pay for lunch. And but I met her at the school. Who asked the question? Yeah. I met her at the school where we taught. Can I say something about professional marriage? I met her because she was beautiful and she was smart. We could talk about politics and religion and poetry and all that good stuff. It would have been nice had she been a great singer. She's not. It would have been nice if she could have been a great keyboard player. She wasn't. And there's something in musical heads of guys, I think, especially. They always think it would be nice if she could do all these. So I would advise you find somebody that you're involved with and marry them, and don't just marry a good partner on the stage or that happens sometimes in our field, maybe a little bit too much. And so I think this would be good. Just find this somebody you love. The fact that she happened to be a great lyricist. I mean, I got to tell you, that lady can put a lyric together better than anybody ever. That's all the poems. Mark Lowry kids me a lot about that. Say, you knew me on the ticket when you signed that. No, it wasn't that. I really loved her. And I still do. I don't always like her, but I still love her. You know, that's a great thing about marriage. I mean, a good marriage, there's always love there. On a given day, you don't like each other, but you get through that. But you can't get through the not loving each other. No matter what, you've got to have help. I probably opened up a can of worms. I probably shouldn't be. Yes.
When your kids were younger and you were touring and stuff, how did you handle that? Did they stay at home? Did they travel with you?
I tell you what we did. We try to pass this down to other kids. And here again comes management of your time, your parenting, everything else. I finally said I can. When we started doing something that people liked and they put value to it, they said we'll pay you to do it. And you could come anywhere and do it. I either had to say that phone, and now the day would be the computer or email or mail, period. The phone is either going to dictate our lives and control our lives, or I'm going to control it. So we said very quickly in the early days, we got three kids who are top priorities here. And we're going to go out about 55, 60 dates at the top a year. And we have stayed by that religiously probably for 50 years. We still don't go out anymore than that. I talk to some people, I don't even think it's a good thing to brag about. I've been on the road now for 3 weeks. I don't, I'm, I, maybe you have to every now and then. But talking to people said, you know, we were out 250 days this year. And I said, that is totally too much. Because if you're out that much, you're listening, the lights start shining brighter on the stage than they are at home. And when that happens, buddy, you're in big, 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 big band. And so at that point, I think we have a Christ responsibility to our family and to our kids. And you might want to talk to our kids, because people have said, has it been a plus or minus being with kids? You know, Martin Luther King said there are more things that unite us than those things that divide us. And I believe that is very much true. One thing that when I finally got smart enough, I think it took me until I was about 30, 35, 40, to realize we use a very exclusive language for the most part, just little dumb things and it's an us and them mentality. And if you come out in a crowd with an us and them mentality, you know what? You're going to get a divided, you are going to get a divided audience. We did two videos in Carnegie Hall, and I was eating breakfast next morning with a Jewish businessman there who had been at the performance. For some business, I think some publishing reasons, not even music, but with dealing with some books, with people, written books.